is at the other end of the Pont en Change. Will be very useful.
We've got to get out of here quickly. We're in grave danger. These machines have neither heart nor mind. No mercy can be expected from them.
And where do you hope to find refuge, mon cher voisin? The enemy is everywhere, and they take no prisoners.
Thank you.
This gate has a lock that requires some combination of four letters. There's no point this lock or letter password. I can use to replace this lever.
Dieu soit loué. It is such a blessing to see you safe and sound.
This belongs to you.
Bless you, whoever you are. You have our eternal gratitude.
I believe you've met Monsieur Julien Raymond from Distant Saint-Domingue. He's one of the most eminent members of our organization.
And you, Mademoiselle? What should we call you?
My name is Aegis.
Ah, yes. The Aegis. The mighty shield and scourge of Zeus.
I wonder. Earlier, by the Pont Neuf, when you touched Monseigneur's ring, can you explain what happened?
The ring called to me. It compelled me to reach out and take it.
Come now.
The moment I touched it, I was transported. Somewhere else. It was the same strange world that you were in, Monseigneur.
Hell, you mean?
Or purgatory.
I saw things there. I saw Monseigneur giving a sermon.
What wickedness is this?
This explains the moment when you froze. And this isn't the only time you've experienced something like this, n'est-ce pas?
That is correct. It also happened with two objects I found in Place Dauphine.
And what happened there?
That is where I found your Bible and your cross, Monseigneur.
How did you know they belonged to me?
They demanded to be returned to you. You did not regain consciousness until I did so.
This is madness.
Let us not be so quick to judge, Monseigneur.
I witnessed the moment when your cross was taken from you. Then I saw you being locked in that box.
Et bien voilà. It is just as I suspected. Here, Aegis, look at this. Over the course of my research, I unearthed this ancient document. I believe I have finally uncovered its meaning. It's a triangle with an identical inscription at each corner. Nemi, memory in ancient Greek. Then, in the center, there is an open eye which symbolizes awakening. Do you understand? The images you saw, Aegis, were Monseigneur de la Fare's own memories. Three echoes of the past tied to personal objects of his. Three Nemi's memories which some dark alchemy had taken from him. Without them, his mind would have remained lost, incomplete. He would never have regained consciousness. But by returning these three objects to him, Aegis, you were able to save his immortal soul.
Tell me, Aegis, when you were at the clerk's office at the Châtelet, did you perhaps see a leather wallet near the abbot's documents?
No, Monseigneur.
Ah, that is unfortunate. Most unfortunate.
Monseigneur? What task did you entrust to the abbot?
The Holy Office ordered me to keep an eye on the Comte de Cagliostro. This charlatan imagines himself to be the heir of Mesmer, the magnetizer, and seems to have ingratiated himself with the king. There have been disturbing reports about him that could lead to his excommunication. It is said that he can make the dead speak. Can you imagine? I asked the abbot to investigate the surroundings of Eugène de Vaucanson's workshop, where the Count had been seen coming and going for several weeks. I cannot disclose the details of what he discovered there, but it may well be related to the events that have plunged Paris into mourning.
I bid you farewell, Monseigneur.
Wait just a moment, s'il vous plaît. You are one of Cagliostro's creatures, are you not?
What do you mean?
When did you awaken?
I do not understand, Monseigneur.
Well, that is to say, you talk, you think, you seem to act with some sort of free will. This was not always the case, that much is clear. You must agree that not all automates are as sophisticated as yourself. I'm attempting to unravel the mystery of your true nature. Tell me, what are your very first memories?
That is a question I am unable to answer.
How strange. In that case, you must surely be able to tell me who taught you what you know.
What I know, Monseigneur?
How can I put it in a way that you'll understand? For example, you call me Monseigneur. How do you know that this is how one addresses a member of the clergy of my rank?
I cannot explain it. I believe...
Go on, Aegis.
I believe that this knowledge is not mine.
Well, I never. Did you hear that, Abbot?
I caught every word, mon ami.
Monseigneur? Mon père.
Plus tard, s'il vous plaît. I need a moment alone. I must read over my notes in light of what we have just discovered.